One of the ways I like to invest and make my money grow is through cryptocurrency. Now, as you probably know, or hopefully know, cryptocurrency is very volatile, and like any investment, there are risks involved. There are many ways to invest your money in crypto, straight up buying and selling of coins, whether that's short-term trading or long-term investing, yield farming, staking, mining, etc., etc. Now, one of the most profitable ways that I've made money recently is staking in yield farms on the new crypto.com VVS finance platform. I made over $700 in little over a week using this method. However, it seems that many people are having real difficulty staking on the new VVS platform. So hopefully this video will make it crystal clear and show you how to add CRO to Cronos, how to swap CRO to VVS, how to create liquidity tokens, how to stake using your liquidity, how to harvest your gains, and then how to unstake your investment. Now, this video is not financial advice, but just a quick walkthrough of staking and unstaking on this platform. I made $700 in a little over a week. Your mileage may vary. You could lose all of your money. Staking in cryptocurrency is not guaranteed to earn you any money at all. And in fact, you could lose money very, very quickly. So only invest what you can safely afford to lose. With that being said, let's jump into it. Okay, so jumping over to the phone, we want to go to our crypto.com DeFi wallet. Now, you need to have the DeFi wallet in order to stake on the VVS Finance site. So we need to make sure that we've got some CRO tokens in our wallet. If we haven't, then we can always transfer some over from the crypto.com app. Now, if we go down to the bottom of the phone, we can see here we've got this DApps, and on DApps we've got VVS Finance, Cronos Chimp Club, and Beefy Finance. We're obviously only interested in the VVS Finance site. So we can get to the site by clicking on that link at the bottom there, DApps, or back in our wallet, we can go down to this Cronos Beta here and choose that. And that also takes us to the VVS Finance site. But before we do all of that, the first thing we need to do is migrate some of our CRO tokens from our DeFi wallet over to the VVS Finance site. Now, the way we do that is through this Cronos Beta bridge. So we click on here, Bridge Through Chains. We want to be sending CRO tokens from crypto.org mainnet, which is our DeFi wallet, to the Cronos Beta. Now, I'm going to be sending over just $200 for this example. Let's just have a look at the currency converter here. $200 is currently £150. £150 worth of CRO tokens. CRO is currently at 56 pence. So £150 divided by 56 pence is 267 tokens. I'm going to send over 280 just to make sure that I've got enough for fees, and there's network fees whenever you convert one coin to another. So just to make sure that we've got enough, I'm going to send over more than we need. So going back to the DeFi wallet, I'm going to send over 280 CRO, which is £156.74 transfer. Now, there's no fee for transferring from the DeFi wallet over to the VVS Finance or through the Cronos Bridge, which is good. So request submitted for 280 CRO. Hopefully this won't take too long. There's been a lot of congestion on the network with this being a relatively new platform. Well, that's gone through already, so that's good. So now that we've sent some money across through the bridge, we need to go back to the VVS Finance site. And if we look under here in our wallet, we should be able to see we've got a CRO balance of 280 coins. Now, in order to stake in any of these farms, because we've got two coins that we stake in, so in the top one we've got Crow and ETH, and then Crow and Wrapped Bitcoin, we're going to be staking Crow VVS, which is currently 699.93% APR. In order to stake in any of these platforms, we need to have an equal amount of both tokens. So the way we do that is we go over to this trade icon here. So we've got Bling Swap, and we want to swap half of our CRO tokens to VVS tokens. Now obviously we want to keep some of these CRO tokens in here for fees, so we're only going to use 270 as our total amount. So half of 270 is 135, and we're swapping to VVS, so we've got 729,207 VVS tokens. So we click on swap, we'll be swapping 135 for 729,000. Accept. We can see here what the price is for doing that, and that's changed pretty quickly, so we need to be quick. So confirm swap, swapping 135 CRO for VVS. So that's been submitted, and we should get a message up in a second to say that that's been done. There we go, transaction receipt, and we can view this on the Cronos Explorer if we want to see that transaction, but we won't. So if we come back to our wallet, we can see that we've got an equal amount of CRO and VVS. Okay. So next thing we want to do on this trade is we want to go to this liquidity button here. Okay, so you can see them next to one another, and we want to add liquidity. So we want to add liquidity for CRO and VVS. So the first input token is CRO, and the second input token is VVS. We want to click on max, so we've got the total of all our CRO and VVS, and we want to click supply and then confirm supply. We can see that it's costing us a little bit of network fee here, 2.1 CRO in order to do that, provide that liquidity. So once we've done that, the transaction submitted, we should get notification to say that's completed. There we go, transaction receipt. Now once we've done that, we've got liquidity here, we can see, of 9555 liquidity tokens for VVS CRO. So the final step is we click on earn, we go to farms, we come down to CRO VVS farm, we click on stake LP, which is stake our liquidity. We're going to stake our total balance of 9555. Click max, confirm. This is going to cost us 0.7 CRO. So as you can see, all these little transaction fees add up. So you need to make sure that you've got enough CRO in there for these fees. So this might take just a little second. Your funds have been staked in the farm. So there we go, we can see that we've got $200.51 staked into this liquidity pool, and now it's just a case of waiting for the liquidity pool to do its thing and earn us some money. Now I'll come back to this in just a short while so we can see what's actually happened in an hour or two, and we can make sure that that is actually earning us some VVS tokens. Okay guys, so we're back after a couple of hours of leaving our staked money into the CRO VVS liquidity pool. So let's log into the DeFi wallet and we can check the status of that. Now I don't expect to have earned too much rewards just yet after a couple of hours, and we've only invested $200, but it's just an idea so you can see how the process works. So we're back into the VVS finance page, and as you can see, our total deposits is now $199.19, which means we've lost some of our initial deposit. That's due to the price of CRO or VVS going down. We can see we've got 35 cents that we've earned from the yield farm. So we can harvest this now, or we can wait till tomorrow or the next week, whenever we want to harvest this. Obviously, if we harvest it now, the network fee is probably going to be more than the actual amount we're harvesting, but we'll do it just for the purposes of this video. So half a CRO token, which is probably about what we've earned. Now the network seems to be quite congested at the moment. I've been having problems with this. Yeah, the network may be congested. Please try again to confirm the transaction. Okay, so we can't do that. But if we go to the farms page, I can show you how we can unstake. So we go back to the farm, and where we've got this plus and minus sign here, we click on the minus. Max, we want to unstake the total amount that we've invested, the total amount of liquidity. Click confirm. Now, I don't know if this will work with the network being congested, but we can try. Okay, so the earnings have been harvested and the stake has been unstaked. That's good. So now that we've unstaked the liquidity, we click on the liquidity tab. We click on the VVS CRO liquidity. We click on remove. We click max because we want to remove all of the liquidity. We will receive 735397 VVS and 133 CRO. Click remove. Click confirm. We will be charged 1.82 CRO for this. Transaction submitted. We can click close there, and then we should get a message to say the transaction receipt to say that that has been approved. Now if we go back to our wallet, we can see that we have 137.64 CRO and 738012 VVS. So then how do we get this money back into our DeFi wallet? So we've already got 137 CRO. We've also got 738000 VVS. We want to convert that into CRO. Click on max. That's all of the VVS converts to 133 CRO. Click swap, confirm swap. It's going to cost us another one CRO. And there's notification to say that that has taken place. If we then go back to our wallet, we can see in our wallet we have 270 CRO and 0 VVS. So if you remember from the start, we actually transferred over 280 CRO, so we've lost 10 CRO due to the fees and also due to the fact that the price of CRO and or VVS have reduced. So this process of creating this video for you guys has cost me 10 CRO, which is about £5.60. Hopefully I'll recoup that somewhere, but hopefully you get a good idea of how this works. And now the final step is getting the money back from the Cronos mainnet or from VVS Finance back to our DeFi wallet, and we do this by using the Cronos Bridge again. Click on Bridge. This time, instead of going from crypto.org mainnet to Cronos Beta, we're going to switch these around by pressing this little icon in the middle. We're going to go from Cronos Beta to crypto.org mainnet. We want to click on Max. There we can see our 270 CRO. We click on Transfer. The bridging service fee has been waived, and we confirm transfer. The request has been submitted. And that money should be back in our wallet very soon. There we go. The transaction has been completed, so that will be back to our DeFi wallet. Now, obviously, as I said at the start of this video, you know, I made quite some decent money out of this. I think I made around about $700 or something. I think we could probably see if we go onto the dashboard here. We can see the total platform yield is $733. And the majority of that was from investing my money into the CRO VVS liquidity pool within the first week of this being launched, and the APRs were really high. Both the value of the CRO token and the VVS token were high, but after about a week I started to see that profit dropping and dropping and dropping, and my initial principal money started decreasing because the value of the VVS token was going down. So you need to be very, very careful when you're investing into these tokens. You know, you can potentially lose a lot of money if the price of the coins goes down. Also, there's things like rug pulls, which you can read into. I'm not going to go into that here. In fact, you know, there's so much information, I couldn't possibly go into that here. Also, things like impermanent loss, that's something you also need to look into before you invest any money into these liquidity pools. It is a very, very risky game, and you really should only be investing money into these kind of pools if, you know, it's money you can afford to lose. Now, I most recently invested in the CROWBTC, Wrap Bitcoin Farm, and that was earning me probably, I think it was about $150 per week or something like that for the last week on average. The pool that we've just looked at, the example I've gone through in this video here, was the CROVVS pool. Now, that's obviously got a higher APR than the CROWBTC pool. We only invested $200, which yielded us something like 20 cents in a couple of hours. If we click on this little button here next to the APR, we can use this calculator to see how much we would potentially earn had we invested more money. So we invested $200, and that gives us over one day $3.83. Over the course of a week, that would be $28.42, and over a month, $153. Now, obviously, the more you increase your stake, the more money you can make. So $2,000 over a day will give us $38 a day. Over a week, $284. Over 30 days, $1,500. So now it starts becoming really worthwhile. If you look at, say, investing $5,000 into this pool, over one day, you're going to earn $95 a day, $700 a week, $3,835 over 30 days. So it does become really, really profitable. But obviously, that initial $5,000 you've invested is at risk, and you need to be very, very careful, like I say. So as much as it does sound great to be investing in these things, there are potentials to really lose some money. So you need to be very, very careful, guys. So hopefully that tutorial gives you an idea of how to stake in these liquidity pools. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments box down below, and I'll be sure to get to them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in a new video. Thank you.